button right there. To let the doors in, go hard, oh, yeah, oh, yeah. I'm going all
What's good, bro?
What's up, man? I'm chilling at the house. I just got done eating some, some rice, chicken, some broccoli. I'm feeling good. What about you, man?
Just got back from my little morning workout, man. Just kind of chilling. Getting ready for the day, bro. But not much, man. Not much.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It's pretty nice out today, man. But who we about to have on the show today, man?
So we're about today's guest is Alysa Horn. She has her own company, Make Yourself AK. It's she does strength and conditioning as well as like a little basketball. She does a little bit of everything, man. She has a couple of degrees in nutrition, athletic training, as well as some other things. She was a NCAA championship finalist with UAA, Western Region champion, two-time conference champion. And she also played professionals in Germany and Australia, man. So it's definitely going to be an exciting episode. I'm looking forward to learning a lot.
Yep, let's get it. Let's dive into it, man. Let's go.
Yes, sir. It's time.
Sorry, guys.
No, you're good.
Good.
I was chatting with my roommate.
All good, all good. How you doing?
How you
doing? Doing great. You know, just chilling at the house, quarantine vibes. Just making do what we got. You know, how are you doing?
Oh, the same. Missing athletes and working in a gym and not my house. It's really hard.
Oh, yeah. It's different, you know, like doing like virtual training or just like training at the crib, doing garage workouts and things like that. I see you guys going out to the track, you know, out on the field doing work out there. Like, tell us a little bit about, like, you guys' regimen out there and what you guys are doing to stay in shape.
So, I'm lucky because I have some workout buddies. I was going to a CrossFit gym before the quarantine hit. And so, what we have basically just migrated out to the nearest track. And the group has kind of grown, you know, just people looking to stay active and do something social. So, 7 a.m. every morning. Out there getting better.
You know, we have a lot of athletes that are listening to this podcast, mostly hoopers. I mean, what do you advise them to do during these times?
I think if they have people who they're comfortable going outside and training with, I think finding those people is really important right now. I know for anybody that I train, regardless of age or like their goals, when you have somebody, like, it's like with us when we train people, right? They're more motivated because we're in their corner. But if they can find that with their peers or utilize, like, what you're talking about, the resources that we're all putting out, I mean, that's going to help them a lot. Staying inside and just kind of, I guess, relenting to the situation is the complete, you know, that's the wrong thing to do. So finding people who will push you is huge.
Yeah, and it's like, with that being said, it's always nice to have people to push you, right? Just because, you know, you guys are going after the same goals and you want to see the best in each and every one of you guys, right? So that's some good advice. Everybody, all the youngins, take note of that and go out there and get better with your friends and things like that. So with this podcast, you know, we just want to dive into your story and have a conversation. And really talk and have you talk to the people about just like your journey as far as you coming up from Kodiak, Alaska, till now, right? And so shout out to Kodiak, Alaska, small island out in Alaska, for those who don't know. Alysa, just take us through living in Kodiak and what it was like. You know, tell the viewers and the listeners what it was like in your perspective growing up in Kodiak.
Well, I think growing up in Kodiak is like a lot of places in Alaska, right? It's really remote. There's not a lot that I had access to, like a lot of these kids in rural villages. You're just out there trying to do the best you can with what you have. And I think I'm going to date myself and sound old, but I didn't have things like YouTube and Zoom videos and podcasts that I could listen to get better. So I was just kind of making things up as I went. But it's tough. It's tough even with modern technology right now. Like, I know a lot of villages in Alaska have data caps. You know, they can't stream stuff like we can in Anchorage with our GCI subscriptions, you know? So there's a lot of limitations being an Alaskan. But I think, I don't really like talking about myself, but if it's worth anything to anybody, it does not matter what you have or don't have. If you want something bad enough, you can go out there and achieve it. It's just what you're willing to put in.
Living in Kodiak, you know, as far as that being said, like you play basketball out there. And just like take us through, you know, your season, your 4 years career out in Kodiak and like what it was like.
Many years ago, yes.
long ago.
Thank you. Well, I graduated in 2008. So this was 2004 to 2008. And back then, Kodiak was not good for the girls program. So we had an awesome coach, though. Her name is Amy Fogel. I don't know if you guys have heard of her, but she's actually one of the only state or coaches in the state to have won a state championship with a girls team and a boys team. So in 2001, she did it with the boys. And then in 2010 or 11, I think, when my sister was playing actually on the team, she won it with them. So pretty cool. I got to have her as my high school coach, and she was tough, but she was the first person who believed in me and was willing to invest time in me outside of like practice and that type of thing. And her husband as well, like just they cared, you know, and it's people like that who make me want to do what I do now, because they did it for nothing. You know, they just wanted to see me succeed. And that's really important.
Yeah, that is really important. Just having people like by your corner, by your side. You know, no matter the circumstances, no matter what's going on, like they're for you, like with you and in your company, make yourself, AK, like you're building people and helping build confidence. And that's one thing that I respect about you and what you bring, right, to Alaska, right, is helping bring that confidence to these youngins. Because we, even us grown people, like we need that positivity. We need that push to, you know, become better than ourselves, become better than who we are the previous day.
So you said it's harder because, you know, it's rural, kind of like a Kodiak. So what are some of the extra things you would do those 4 years in Kodiak to kind of separate yourself?
That's a really good question. I spent a lot of time outside, which, right, it's kind of funny right now, right? We're all stuck inside, and the only way that we can get better is going outside to a park. I spent a lot of time doing that. It just was kind of my escape. Like, I was kind of an introverted kid, and secretly, I'm still pretty introverted. Like, and by the way, Jhayde, I really respect what you guys are doing, too. It's awesome to see the give back. You know, like, I love the theme, get better daily. That's, like you said, it doesn't matter your age, what you're doing. That's what it's about getting better daily and working with what you have. So in Kodiak, I mean, that's what I did. Went outside, played on the hoops. I kept bothering Coach Fogel for the keys to the gym. So one day she was like, fine, just take them. And so then I had them for a summer. I was like, this is awesome. This is just me in the gym with my basketball, doing my thing. So yeah, just, you know, using the people that I knew to get better. I just was kind of a student of the people around me. There's a couple trainers who helped me physically get better as well. And that's super important. And another reason I like to do what I do now, you know, it's just really important for people to work on their bodies. If you want to be a great athlete, you have to invest that time. You have to invest it in your skills. You have to invest it in your athleticism. Otherwise, you might get hurt or you might be getting beat out on the court. So it's just really important to learn from the people around you.
Mm-hmm. And like piggybacking off what you said about just learning from your environment, just talk to the kids and talk to everybody about the attribute of having that curiosity, you know, having an open mind. Like, just talk to us, because I mean, he was really curious about like trying to get better, because you had big dreams, you had big aspirations during that time. So just talk to us about that.
Yeah, I love that question. It's all about what you want, right? And it doesn't matter if you are in college or your goal is to play pro. It's really, that's awesome to dream about that. I never knew if that was going to be possible for me, but I always dreamed it. Maybe your goal is just to be a starter next year on varsity, right? So, I mean, you have to be a learner, right? It's just like school. If you want to get good grades, which you should, then you need to be putting in the time and studying and listening to your teachers and genuinely caring about it. If you want to be a great athlete, you have to be curious about going out and learning different things about the game, right? I don't have all the answers. That's why I try to learn from the best coaches from all different walks of life. As an athlete, you guys should be asking questions to the coaches that you know or the players that you look up to. Who cares if you don't personally know them? Reach out to them on Facebook or Instagram. Be like, hey, like some of the UA athletes, I guarantee you they'll get back to you. I work with them. They're awesome. They're like us, you know, they're really, really good. They've made it to the next level. Like, reach out to them, ask them what they did to get there. Be curious to learn that information from somebody who's living that experience. Or Jhayde, for like you, you tore your ACL and you came back and you're probably a better athlete because of it. That's happening to people all over the place. What is it like to have that adversity? What is it like to get through it? How did you get better from it?
That being said, yes, thank you for like giving that information to kids, because we all have the resources. We all have YouTube. We all have Instagram, Facebook, Twitter. Like, you take that time to really invest in your mind and just use the resources you have around you, right? And so, I mean, just to answer your question, though, with the ACL, it just took patience. Like, and so I remember just writing on my whiteboard saying, I want to become the most physically, mentally, and spiritually healthy I can be, like, ever, you know, by the end of this ACL surgery, right? And so with that being said, I was just grinding, reading books, listening to podcasts, taking my PT serious, because I never know when I'm going to get this opportunity again to even have physical therapy. Not a lot of people have that opportunity to even have like insurance or like enough money to have copay to do physical therapy. So I was really taking the time, right, and like investing in my body so that in the long run, I can do what I do now and doing what you do too. Like, all of us, we all help train kids and help them become better. It's not even about us, right? It's about the next generation. And so that was like my big why, was just like, got people depending on me, so I got to be healthy. Like, you know, so that's just what I got to say about that. But anyways, transitioning from Kodiak, you got an opportunity to go play at UAA. So just talk to us about the transition from playing high school ball to going to UAA.
Ooh, it's tough. It's like you think of college as the next step, right? Except for that step is like three flights up. It's a crazy jump. And depending on what opportunities you've been given in high school or AAU basketball, you may or may not be ready for it. And for me, coming out of Kodiak, I thought I was ready, and I was not. Everybody was bigger, stronger, faster. They knew their IQ was way better. Like, I was just really, really behind. And it was tough. I redshirted my first year because I wasn't ready. And I fully invested in getting better that year, but the next year, it still wasn't enough, right? UAA at the time was a powerhouse. We were really good. They had made it to the Final Four, I think, the year before that I got there. And so, yeah, our coaches had very high expectations, and that's not atypical, you know? Like, when you go to college, the coaches, in a way, they're paying you. You're on a scholarship. They own you. It's not like high school, where if you're not getting playing time, you can't have your mom or dad go to bat for you, which, by the way, I would not recommend doing that. Mm-hmm. I would recommend talking to your coach and asking them what you can do to get better. But in college, sometimes coaches, it's more transactional, which is not great, right? But you are there to help the program, and you're only there for a short amount of time. And at the end of the day, they care about winning. You know, there's a lot of pressure on college coaches to win. So if you're not contributing to that, they might treat you a certain type of way that you're not used to from high school. And that was another big thing that I had to learn and that I didn't really understand at first, because I was giving everything that I had to get better and to be a better player for the team, you know, and to do my part. But it was never really reciprocated because I didn't, you know, I wasn't contributing to winning at the time. So long story short, I put in the work to on my own to make that happen. And by my sophomore year, it was different and I was playing a little bit more. But yeah, it's just some people, they can go in right away into college and make an impact. Other people, and I've noticed this especially with Alaskans, they redshirt or it takes them a little while, right? For example, Hannah Wanderstein and Tara Thompson, who have graduated, their first year they had a redshirt too. By the time they were done, they are some of the most winningest players in the UA women's basketball history to come through the program, and they were major impact players, but it took a while. Like you said with your intro, you have to be patient. Things don't just happen.
Mm-hmm. Like, just like, it's a marathon, you know, it's not a race, it's a marathon. You got to take it day by day. And like, I know, I mean, I was a redshirt after my prep school year. I went to Fort Lewis College and I redshirted, and I know how tough it is to, you know, just not be able to play and contribute, but you still got to stay ready, right? Stay in shape, get just keep your game sharp, you know, and I mean, find runs, because you can't really, you don't have that type of game atmosphere. I remember going and playing like intramurals during my redshirt year, because I really wanted to have like referees and have like an official score to play to. But just take us through what, like, specific things like you had to do, you know, during your redshirt year, right? Just so that you, because I know your sophomore year, you like made a big leap from redshirt year to your sophomore year, right? And so, or your freshman year, sophomore year, the next couple
years. Redshirt year, freshman year, and then my third year, my sophomore year. That's when it happened for me.
Yeah, so like, take us through your summer, right? Like, how did you get better? Like, what were you doing?
Oh gosh, people aren't gonna like to hear this, because the answer was not easy. I had to really embrace being uncomfortable and doing things I didn't want to do. Like the only times that we could get in extra meaningful work, because as a red shirt, you know, or a practice player, you're kind of there when they need you. So we played a lot of defense in practice, or we just watched the team work on plays and et cetera, you know. So we went to the gym at 10 p.m. to shoot, because that's the only time it was open for us. Or we woke up at 6 a.m. for workouts, you know. I had to ask my coach, I had a huge fear of going in and talking to my coach, but I had to take moments to be like, hey, how can I get better? Like, I don't know, but I know that I'm not where I need to be. So what do I need to do? And I didn't always like the answer. Like some of the times she just was brutally honest. I was like, okay, then that's what I have to do. And then right now, like the off season for basketball, that's when the magic happens, and no, you're not getting credit for it. Like, that's what I think a lot of young people, like you guys listening to this right now, I don't think you understand that yet. It's right now that matters the most. Like, this is where you get better as a player, as a person, everything. Like, it's not happening during the season. That's when you're supposed to shine. Right now you're working on that sparkle, you're working on the magic. So take advantage of this, right? Like, just fully invest in yourself and becoming better.
Mm-hmm. That's what it takes, you know? Like, that's really what it takes to be in the gym in the trenches, right? And just to be prepared for that one moment for you to help your team, right? In that one moment, in that arena.
Yeah, and I mean, I would encourage everybody to train, like, train with you, train with me, train with as many coaches as possible. And then what you learn in those sessions, go out and repeat it like 50 times over before we see you again. Mm-hmm. It like, take advantage of us, because we've been there, we know, like, we have those tools. There's nothing that replaces good coaching. Like, YouTubing and going out and trying to do it on your own, that's one thing. But if you can get in touch and train with a good coach, that is exponentially better. And then go work on those skills on your own time, right?
Yeah, like we're gonna hold you accountable, like right then and there, right? If you go on YouTube, because I mean I'm not saying I'm a victim to it, but like I've watched YouTube, like I do drills, like watch the YouTube videos, do the drills right away. Like I don't have anybody looking at me if I'm going hard or not, which I was going hard at the whole time, but with technique, with just the little things, the minute details, nobody's watching me and correcting me on it. So we would just, I mean, but we may do what we got, right? But we're here, we have Alysa, we have Don, we have me, like we have Muff, we have Neil, everybody, use your resources, right, to become the best player that you want to be just based on your goals.
Alysa, so that summer, like, you kind of talked a little bit of your physical, like, this is kind of, I feel like, a understated, like, part of the game is, like, your mental. So there's this quote that we saw that said, your coach told you, if you don't get better, you will not play more than 5 minutes a game. So with that, what was kind of your mental through that phase of transitioning? Like, what are some things you did to help better it and things of that sort?
I also love that question because the mental side of it is huge. And that's one thing that's really hard to teach yourself. That's where asking good questions comes in, like to people who have lived it and have been. But when my coach told me that, the first like 15 minutes after, I was heartbroken because that was that second year of college. And I was like, what are you talking about? Like, I have been working so hard to try to make it. And you're grinding and doing everything that you guys are asking. And here you are telling me right to my face that it's still not good enough. Like, I couldn't even believe it. And then I got really mad. And I was like, there's no way that now she's going to be right. Like, there's no way. And so the second that I got home, so that in that 15 minutes, I drove from my coach's offices back to my dorm to start packing up to go home for the summer. And I got on Amazon right away and I ordered like a heavy basketball and just a couple other things that I knew. I was like, these will make me better. So I did that and I started planning out what I was going to do that summer. I'm going to wake up at 6 a.m. because in Kodiak, they had this thing called Powerball. I don't know if they still do it, but a bunch of old guys and just, you know, random young guys around town would go play. I was literally the only girl who would show up, but I did that like three or four days a week. And then I worked on my body, like got in better shape and I worked on my skills and I had it all planned out. Like, this is what my week looks like. And then I started changing my nutrition habits. Like, I'm fully invested now because she's going to be wrong. And I kind of felt like I had the weight of Kodiak a little bit. Like, I can't let my town down either, you know, that hometown pride. So yeah, back to the mental training point or mental standpoint though, another thing that I ordered was a book called Mind Gym, and it's by Gary Mack. And I encourage everybody to get this book and read it. It's not like a crazy read. It'll probably, if you're a good reader, it'll probably take you a week. But he has these small lessons per chapter on things that I guarantee everybody listening to this has experienced. And at the time, you probably didn't know how to get through that. Like, how do you get through failure? Like, I've experienced this really difficult thing. Like, it sucks. I don't know how to get through it. That they outline those things. So just like we train our bodies, like you do push-ups to train, you know, I want to get more powerful with my upper body, I'm going to do push-ups. I need to get more explosive, I'm going to do squats and box jumps. You know, he teaches you how to train your mind to get through like really relevant stuff to basketball, but also stuff that's going to translate over into your life too and how to be a successful person that way.
Okay. What were some key quotes or concepts that you took from that book?
Consistency, like you're talking about, it's not a sprint. Getting better is not going to happen overnight. It takes a lot of time. Commitment, fully committing to the process of that and not just expecting that I worked really hard for a summer, now I'm going to show out. You know, you have to keep working. Confidence, like I know for young athletes, regardless if you're a girl or a guy, confidence is huge. So they teach ways that you can improve your confidence. I think those are the big ones for me, but there's a lot of other stuff in there that they're just, it's all gold.
Nice. Appreciate that. The recommendation. I'm going to go, I've seen it at Barnes and Nobles. I haven't had the chance to pick it up. I'm still finishing one of the one books, The Champion's Mind, How to Think, Train, and Thrive by Jim Aframo. I'm still trying to finish that one, and then I'm going to get in mind, Jim.
Just okay, let's check it out.
Yeah, because Alysa recommended it. I'm about to go cop that. But with that being said, we like to do quick hitters. So Don and I are just going to go rapid fire, ask you questions back and forth, and then you're just going to say the first thing that pops up into your mind, okay?
Ooh, okay. This could be scary. Let's do it.
You got it. All right, ready?
Ready.
All right, here we go. Favorite quarantine snack?
Popcorn.
Favorite place to vacation?
Ooh, Kodiak.
Best basketball kicks of all time?
Oh, man. I'm not a shoot person. I can't answer that.
All right, it's good. Pass it. You can pass.
Pass.
Favorite movie?
Unbroken.
If you can choose one Gatorade flavor, what would it be?
Definitely orange.
Ooh, okay, orange. I like that.
Under Armour or Adidas?
Under Armour or Adidas?
Yeah.
None of the above. None of the above.
She said straight Nike. Straight Nike.
Nike.
Nike's where it's at.
My bad.
I never heard that one before. Under Armour or Adidas.
Everybody always say Nike, bro. Everybody just be like, Nike.
That's true.
Netflix or show you're binging right now?
Chef's Table.
Ooh. Making me
hungry. It's good. It's good.
I'm going to have to check that out.
Favorite basketball player?
Pass.
And then let's see, Kalates or Starbucks?
Kalates, 100%.
Yes.
Let's go.
How much time we got, Don?
That's time.
Oh, yep. That was fun. I liked it. Come on, Kalates all the way.
They always do.
Oh, definitely.
And then orange. Go again. Say that again.
Oh, I was going to say, they sell Kalates at Costco. It's just, like, in a different packaging.
Mm-hmm. What's your, like, favorite brew?
Oh.
Yeah, she's about to put you on, man.
To pull it out. Hey, put us on. Put us on, Alysa. Okay. The Silver Hook. Kodiak. Organic.
Come on. Told you, hometown reppin'.
I'm gonna have to try that.
You guys like black coffee drinkers, or how do you drink your coffee?
Yeah, I straight black coffee. That's how I drink.
What?
Yeah. I don't put anything.
You're sick.
I just that's how I do it. Americanos or black coffee. Whatever. That's just me.
Americano too, but I got a little cream.
Okay, got a little flavor in there.
Yeah.
So now, like, done with college, right, you have the opportunity to go play overseas. So you've played 2 years in Germany and a year in Australia, that's correct, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So just, like, take us through that pro journey, and, like, having your dreams really come into fruition. Like, just talk to the viewers, talk to the players, talk to whoever's listening about that experience and what it was like.
Yeah, it was really cool, but it was also really hard. I kept, like, achieving these things that I kept working towards, and then it was like the next thing was just, it was hard, you know. It just kept getting harder. Like, I'd do good, and it'd be really, really hard to get it. Like, do good, it'd be really, really hard to get. So it's just that constant climbing the staircase, where the next level that you get to, it's like, whoa, these are completely new challenges. But yeah, it was tough being away from home, but it was really cool getting to experience basketball in different areas of the world.
what are some like memorable moments that you have, whether it's like, you know, something funny that happened, or, you know, something that a coach yelling at you? What are some just, you know, good times that you have?
Well, my second year in Germany, we ended up winning the championship. So in Germany, you have like levels, right? So Division One, Division Two, Division Three. And if you win your division, you move up to the next division. And if you get last place in that top division, you move down. So I was in the second division, and that year we won. But it was a really, really interesting journey. And I tell you what, like, if your goal is to play pro and sell out in college and enjoy that experience, do not rush into going pro, because it's totally different, especially if you play overseas. Like, the coaching in the U.S. is, it just doesn't really get any better. Unless you're at a really, really high level, right? But I would assume that comparably, if you're at the highest level in a small country in Europe, and you're comparing it to the highest level in the U.S., U.S. is going to win out every time, right? So long story short, the experience that second year, being on one of the best teams, our coach just, he didn't really know how to manage the team very well. And I'll never forget one game we were losing to a really bad team. And at halftime, he just starts yelling in German. And I'm like, I don't know what you're saying. And so when he would like, yeah, he would kind of stop to catch his breath or whatever. And like one of the mates would lean over to me and she would kind of like translate. And then he'd start yelling again. She'd be like, thanks. Okay. So I don't know. There's a ton of kind of moments like that where you just, oh, here's another one for you. In my very first year, I got over there, and like 3 days later, we had to play in this tournament. And for whatever reason, Germans like fizzy water, like kind of like LaCroix, you know. But they drink that during games. And so they had this case of water in there. I was like, oh, thank goodness, I'm so thirsty. Like, I need some of this water. And I opened it, and I didn't hear it go. Oh. And so I start like drinking a lot of it while the coach is talking. I'm like, no. out. So yeah, all sorts of surprises playing in a different country.
All different types of surprises, like different food too. Well, how was the food like? Was it tasty? I mean, compared to US or?
Yeah, no, German food is really, really good. I think it's a lot like US, only more meat and potato-y, if we can beat that out here in the U.S. I feel like maybe the Midwest might be on that level, but they eat a ton of bread over there and a lot of meat, a lot of potatoes. Australia is kind of the same way.
Is there anything that you want to tell the listeners, or give like advice, or just anything, like you want to come from the heart, and or what, anything that like you would tell to the viewers right now during these times, you know, like during these quarantine times?
Definitely. My advice to everybody is, we're all going through this. And I know for me personally, it's been really tough. Like, especially when you're self-employed or running your own business like you guys are, it's just really hard. I mean, we're all either financially struggling or having a hard time being away from people, and just try to adapt. You know, don't get comfortable with our circumstances and our situation. Still find ways to make yourself better and to keep pushing. Get creative, right? Like, show up at the track at 7 a.m. Baggage Middle School and just be like, hey, I want to work out too, you know? Or like, I saw you guys are doing sand dunes, show up at the sand dunes. Mm-hmm. Find those people who are going to push you and make you better, not the people who are going to sit on the couch with you and watch Netflix. Like, and still focus on school. Like, that's huge too. I saw some crazy statistic the other day that like 60% of seniors hadn't logged into their classes. Do your school. Like, why are we stopping learning?
Yeah, we got to finish it out, especially if you're a senior, right? We got to finish it out. You're already like 99% of the way there. Just finish it out. So appreciate that.
And then what are some things that you guys are currently doing, or that you got going on for yourself and like your business that, you know, the viewers or just people kind of look forward to?
Yeah, thank you for asking that. I have a lot of things in my brain right now that I want to start doing, especially from a sports performance standpoint, like strength and conditioning and character development type stuff. But there's just so much that I'm trying to get caught up on right now that I guess people can maybe look forward to that within the next few weeks. But yeah, just keep, you know, keep in touch. And if anybody has questions or needs anything, just always reach out. I'll always get back to you. And I appreciate you guys doing this podcast and making us available to people. It's huge.
No, yeah. Thank you for like agreeing to hop on, you know, like it's fun to really talk to people that like have the same type of goals that like we have. And it's just like, it's refreshing as well.
Totally.
You know, during these times. And before anything, I always like to end the podcast with just one question. So knowing what you know now, like being going through all the experiences that you've been through, what would you tell that freshman high schooler, Alysa Horn, knowing that she wants to pursue all these goals? Like, what would you tell her right now?
Get in the weight room. Seriously. Learn how to move your body properly. Because right now I've herniated a few discs in my back and I've joints messed up all over the place. And it's not because I wasn't working hard. I was just working wrong. And it's really important for young athletes, especially, to learn how to move the right way off of the court so that when you get onto the court, right, basketball is a pretty abusive sport on your body, that you're better equipped to not get hurt. And that happens, like, that doesn't happen when you have a ball in your hands.
Yeah.
So.
And then just to end off, where can people find you? Let them know.
My website is makeyourselfunstoppable.com. And then my social media handles are makeyourselfak. So, yeah, find me on there. Ask questions. I have a ton of resources on my website. I have garage workouts posted. So take advantage of that. Like, a lot of what I do is for free. So
appreciate you, Alysa. Thank you for hopping on the show. And best of luck to you and everything that you're doing. And we're going to have to, like, link up soon and do some camps together.
Definitely.
Yes. Oh, for sure. I'm down, you guys. Thank you for what you guys are doing. Appreciate you both.
Gotcha. I'm going all in this house vibes.